Hi there. In this video, I want to talk about the harmonica equivalent of the saying, life imitating art. In this case, I'm talking about how I'm trying to get a traditional analog harmonica to do what my MIDI harmonica can do, specifically to do with bending notes. Now, my MIDI harmonica, this is the LEKHOLM DM48X. I've got it set up so it can bend notes a semitone, two semitones, or three semitones, and that'll work on any note. So, you know, for example, on this note here, I can bend it down a semitone, two semitones, or three semitones. So that's a draw note, but I can do that on blow notes as well. Okay, now that kind of thing is not possible on traditional harmonicas. The amount you can bend a note is determined by the pitch of the opposing breath reed. So here's an example. This is a Lucky 13 in power chromatic tuning in G, and I'm playing in the key of D. And here's that note that I played on the MIDI harmonica, which is actually an F sharp note. Okay, so it's an F sharp draw note. And in that hole is a blow note, which is an E. So in between, there's a chromatic note that I can bend the F sharp down to. Okay, that's the F note. But on my MIDI harmonica, you know, I can take that note there and I can bend it down to the F, or I can bend it down to the E, or I can bend it down to the E flat. Okay, now, in my particular case, what I'm wanting to do is get a full tone bend on my harmonica, as well as the semitone bend, and use them optionally. So I've written a little tune recently, which I was using to explore bending on the MIDI harmonica, I've just called it Larkin, Larkin About maybe, something like that. Anyway, on the DM48X, I can switch between semitone and two semitone down bends whenever I want, just by moving my finger on this bending pitch ribbon. So, you know, the phrase goes like this. So you can hear I'm going from the F sharp down to the E as a bend. Now on my Lucky 13 or any other harmonica that was tuned in the same tuning, I'd only get that semitone bend. Okay, I can only bend that F sharp down to the F. I can't bend it all the way down to the E. In this particular case, I really want to get that deep bend on my traditional harmonica as well as the MIDI harmonica. So, how do I do that? Well, I had a bit of a think about it and I came up with two different ways to do it on two different kinds of harmonica. But they're both based on the same logic. Well, one way to achieve this is to use a specialist diatonic harmonica. And in this case, I'm using a SEYDEL. It's in power chromatic tuning in G. I'm playing in D, as with the Lucky 13. But this one has got the Jim Antaki's TURBOSLIDE added to it, because the SEYDEL's got the metal reeds, the TURBOSLIDE's got tiny magnets, and that means you can lower the blow notes by, in this case, a semitone. So if you lower the blow note a semitone, that means I can lower my draw bend a semitone as well. So have a listen. So here's that F sharp note, the draw note, and here's my blow note, the E. And, you know, without using the turbo slide, I can only get a semitone bend. Okay, I can go down to that F, as on the Lucky 13. But now, listen to what the turbo slide does. That's the blow note. That's the E going down to an E flat. But the good thing is that the F sharp stays in the same airstream as that E flat. And that means I can get an interaction between the two reeds. And because the blow note's going down a semitone, I can bend my draw bend down a semitone as well. So here's the, again, without any turbo slide. And now with the turbo slide. Okay, so now I'm bending that F sharp down all the way down to the E, which is normally the blow note. Okay, so that's really cool. So this now allows me to play that same melody that I was getting on the MIDI harmonica. I can now get that on a real harmonica. As opposed to... Okay, so you can hear that there I'm, this is where it's like life imitating art. It's basically getting the analog harmonica to, give me something that I'm getting from my MIDI harmonica. And that can be done by, again, using a specialist harmonica. As I say, I'm playing a power chromatic tuning. If you play on Richter tuning, you can get exactly the same effects. And I put some links in the description below to some videos I've done where I've demonstrated how you can get these extra lower bends on a Richter-tuned harp as well. The cool thing is it gives you lots of nice alternate phrasing for licks. Where you would normally use a blow note, now you can opt to use a draw bend instead. For example, the end phrase of that little melody. So, now what I could do there is use a couple of bends, which is, got a lovely soulful quality to it. It gives you new flavors. There's another lick in the that I play in the melody, which is using a full tone bend on the fifth of the scale, which in this case it would be an A note. So, and on my MIDI harmonica again. So that's over the over the seventh chord. So you really need that's the seventh note that I'm bending from. On a normal harmonica, like my Lucky 13, I wouldn't be able to get that seventh bend. I can only get the semitone bend. So you can hear the difference there. Going all the way down to that seventh, which is if I maybe fire up the chords here. Okay, so you can hear there's a seventh chord going on. I really need to play that G note, which is the seventh of the the A seventh chord, and playing a G sharp, it'll kind of work, but it's not the right note. It's more G sharp is for a major seventh chord. So now on my SEYDEL with the turbo slide, I can actually get that G note as well. Hear that? As opposed to... Okay, so it just gives me that correct flavor for the A seventh note, and I can get that using my turbo slide. Now, using the same principle, I had a bit more of a think about it, and I realized that if I were to take a chromatic harmonica, now this is a Hohner CX-12, and tune it to the same tuning, but lower the blow slide notes, a semitone, I'd basically be getting the same as I get on the turbo slide. So here's the scales. This is a, in power chromatic tuning again. So here's... And in this case, I've got it half valved, so every note bends a semitone. Okay, so it's exactly the same as the Lucky 13 that I played you, that I played before. But I want to get that deeper bend. So what I've done is I've lowered the slide note a semitone, but I've left the slide-in draw note up to where it was before. So Again, it's the F sharp note. So now I can bend my F sharp down to the E. Okay, so now I can get that same melody in the same way that I wanted. And I can do that same thing. Anything I can do with the turbo slide, basically, I can now do on this altered slide diatonic harmonica. So that's another way one could achieve the same thing. It's all about basically getting an extra bend, an extra lower bend, which does give you a whole lot of really nice flavors that are actually more appropriate for, certain types of music, certain situations. It's nice to be able to get that deeper bend when you want it. Okay, well, I hope this has proved interesting, thought-provoking for anyone there who loves, bending notes, but has always wished they could bend notes a little bit deeper, a bit further. Well, now you know. There is a way to do it. Bye for now.